everyone, welcome back to my channel today. Today I wanted to talk about kind of a change of thinking that I've been working on the past year, and I think I'm making some progress on it, and I just wanted to talk to you guys about it. So I have a personality that's I'm always just looking for a source of truth, a person that I can always look towards. So, you know, if I have a question on something, I can go to them and like they'll have the right answer, you know, regardless of like I know that their answer is probably the correct one, and that's kind of the perspective I should take. And I've kind of always been like that, but I've realized obviously that's not very productive for myself, or just productive to generate, you know, your own opinions on things or for the larger discourse. I've really challenged myself to critically think about really what I'm reading, what type of information I'm taking in, and even those people that I usually go for, you know, for like a good authority source on something, I'm really starting to like, if I kind of agree on what they're saying, I'm trying to think of counterproductive questions or what somebody would say if they're debating them and stuff like that. And I feel like it's really helped me separate my thinking from just being monolithic and more ideological to, you know, just being thinking that's coming from myself, my individual perceptions of life. So an example of this, I talk about Jordan Peterson all the time, and with his first book, 12 Rules for Life, I read that book in a very, you know, this is kind of the law of the land perception. And obviously that's not like a good perception to always have of things. You should always have an open mind and questioning. But I was just so new to his work and I really enjoyed it. So that's kind of the perspective I took, because I was like, this is awesome. He's talking about all these very interesting topics and I think this is very important. So for reading his second book now, 12 More Rules for Life, I've taken more of a reflective approach. And you know, there's certain statements or, you know, conclusions that he might draw, and I necessarily might not agree with them, or I kind of have a different worldview on it, or, you know, however that happens. And I just wanted to kind of get on here and say that I'm proud of myself that I'm seeing this kind of evolution of my thought, but I'm also cognizant that it's something that we all have as humans, that we always look to something kind of to be the correct answer. Or can we trust them? You know, is the information I'm getting from them, is it something that I can believe throughout, you know, whatever situation's going on? And I think, you know, in the past year and a half, and as like as the media state grows larger and social media also becomes such a large producer of news and information and stuff like that, I think it's really good for ourselves to really focus on not just being intakers of information, but also examining it. And even if we really like this person and agree with them on 40% of the things, maybe let's, you know, think about it and say, hey, maybe I don't really like that perspective, or I have a different idea about it. And on this channel, I always highlight that that is such a healthy and, you know, natural response to things. You shouldn't agree with people all the time, otherwise society and ideas would just be complacent and boring. So I just wanted to talk about kind of the methods that I've used to kind of start critically thinking more. And it's kind of humorous for me because, you know, we should all be critically thinking all the time, but it's so easy just to kind of like go on autopilot, see all this information, think, okay, yep, that's the right thing, keep on scrolling, you know, that's what I should think. So what I've actually done is I've limited the amount of accounts and people that I'm following. I had to unfollow some people that I really liked their ideas, but it was just so much on the timeline. You know what I mean? So I only have accounts that I feel I really like their perspectives. And then I started bringing in accounts that I also have different perspectives from them, you know, just more normally. And then as I'm going throughout my day, you're seeing, you know, different posts, different perspectives, everything like that. I've given myself the space and kind of the chance to disagree with even people that I really admire. And I think that's kind of a healthy thing for me, because I used to think like, no, like if you really look up to this person, Bailey, you should agree with them on everything. And that's something that's been really powerful for me to learn, is you can still critically think and debate ideas about people that you look up to. And also another one of those points is when you're growing up, you kind of look to your parents as the sole authority of topics and decisions and opinions and everything like that. And then as you slowly mature, you get different experiences, different perceptions of things, you start to disagree or just think differently on a few things than your parents, and that's okay. So that's the process that I think we all need to mimic a little bit more sometimes, just with our news feed and the opinions that we're hearing or the relationships or debates that we're having. And it's something that I've had fun doing too, because I'm challenging myself to think about things that I normally wouldn't think about, and I would just kind of embrace as fact or truth or whatever that is. So it's helping me think and form my own opinions while also adding more perspectives to the worldview, I feel like. So let me know if you guys have struggled sometimes with that, of just all this information, and you feel kind of the need to agree with it all, whether you're one side or the other. Stuff like that and that type of feelings. Also, I want to mention that this can be for any type of topics. It just doesn't have to be for social media or current events or anything like that. With anything in life, it's okay to disagree with others around you and still be mostly in accordance to what they're thinking, or support them, or still have the same moral or beliefs, and maybe you just interpret it a little bit differently. But it's really powerful for all of us to just critically think on our own sometimes and not have other people tell us how to critically think. So hope you guys are having a great rest of your day, and thanks for watching.